Hey there, Wingate Football fans. Ryan Brown here down at the Irwin Belk Stadium Football Complex as we get ready for our first episode of the Big Eight as we join Wingate head football coach in his 14th year, Joe Reich, for the Big Eight plays from the previous game each week throughout the 2014 season. Coach Reich with us today, off to a great start for your 2014 season, Coach. 38-10 over Limestone. You start 1-0 for the 12th time in the last 14 years, all under you. Plenty to have, in practice week. A lot of good things, a lot of things you want to work on. Right. Some fun days from some guys. Jacobs, Pittman, Hathaway, all getting their first touchdowns. All around, pretty good day besides, a couple things here and there.
Yeah, it was a fun day. It was a lot of excitement in the air with the first game for Limestone in their school's history, and just there was a lot of fanfare around that, and a lot of energy, a lot of excitement. We talked to our players about that, just the energy and the intensity that was going to be around it, and how we had to be ready for that. Either way, I mean, we didn't know if there were going to be 10 people there or, a bunch of people there. So it was exciting to have a good atmosphere. Certainly, a really, really hot day, a lot of heat, a lot of humidity out there. So it was a lot of fun to see guys step up, like you mentioned. Some guys, some names that we haven't seen before come up and come up big for us. And some old faces that came up really big for us as well.
We're going to go through the biggest eight plays, as we said, from each game this season. Coach Reich will break them down for us after we go over each play. A lot of fun, a lot of good insight to Wingate football and just football in general. So let's talk about these first eight plays. Number one here on the Big Eight was the opening kickoff. Bobby James, first game as head coach. Limestone, first game as a program.
Sure.
What do they do but try a little chip shot onside kick with, a normal formation that lined up everybody right there.
Yeah, great idea.
Luckily, he goes out of bounds.
Yeah, we talked about it beforehand. We said right to the kickoff return team, look, it's going to be an onside. He's going to do something funky. Guarantee it's going to be an onside. That was not the onsides I was planning for, though. So kudos to Bobby James for coming up with that. It's something we had worked on when we were here at different times, and something that I probably should have gone through my mind, but we thought of all the other different onside kicks except for that one. And fortunately enough for us, it was a little high. It is a tough kick to control. If you look at the scheme of things, it's a good scheme if you have a kicker that can do that, can just chip it and just get it about 12 yards and just keep it in bounds. They have a guy there, but a little high. I mean, obviously that's a tough kick to control, and gave us a little bit of momentum coming out. It would have been nice to be able to take advantage of that, but certainly a big play just because right off the bat, they come out, they try something funky, and we're ready for it, and unfortunately we're able to maintain control of the ball. All right, opening kickoff. Again, I think what Coach James is looking at here is saying, okay, there's a little bit of space over here. Probably had looked at some film from last year, and for most teams there's going to be a little bit of space here. It's a very small window. You can see he kicked it through. So it goes about 12 yards. So he gets the distance, but just goes a little too high there. Again, so we get it here, and I believe we get it here, and then it's plus 5 yards from there. So exciting way to start off, the Coach James there, and certainly. He's going to. I think he'll be successful down the road if he's got that gambler's mentality and getting after it.
Play number two here in our Big Eight of Week One with Joe Reich is one of three Nick Napolitano forced fumbles in this game. Nicknamed Sack Player of the Week on the defensive side, first time for him in his career. It was a four-down play. Again, defense really started to settle in here. They got a couple first downs on those first couple drives, but right. Good settle down here. Got a forced fumble, and I know they were counting that as a turnover on downs, right. But in the stats, it was a forced fumble and a fumble recovery. So the defense ended up getting their three.
They got their three turnovers because of that. So I was joking around with them after the game. That was kind of a cheap way to get it, yeah. But that's all right. No, and a big play by Knapp. Certainly a guy that's just been what a mainstay in our program for years now, and a guy that's just done so many great things. Just beating his man off the line. Just he's just a very good athlete. He moves really well. He's got some strength. He's got some explosiveness. He's just a savvy football player to come up, and he's just a great playmaker. So it comes up big for us on the fourth down. Forces the fumble. I believe Jacobs falls on it. And then we get some momentum going there, and it leads to a field goal for us. Okay, big fourth down here. Limestone had a decent drive here. This gives us an opportunity again. Nick Napolitano, inside move, again, just doing a great job. Fundamentally does a great job. Good rip up underneath, gets the sack. And again, it would have been nice if we could pick this one up too, but falling on it even marks it back even further. So instead of getting it, you know, on an incomplete pass here, you know, we've got it up here a pretty good distance, more towards the 50. Great starting field position for the next drive.
Play number three here in our Big Eight is that field goal that Coach Reich mentioned a short time ago. Patrick Smith back for his senior year, coach, and, you know, not a captain, but he's a leader out there. He's got to lead a young special teams group along with the rest of the seniors here. But, you know, couple of drives that stall. Great to get something on the board here. He goes in from 25 yards out, and he had a great year last year. Just didn't need him a ton in a lot of situations.
Sure.
And also had five nice extra points as well.
Yeah, and I believe last year we were actually first in the league in field goal percentage. So, you know, kudos to him. And obviously another guy that made sack player of the week for special teams. Again, I mentioned it before, he's a great leader for that young group. And, you know, those kickers spend a lot of time apart from us doing their thing. And it's nice to know that when I'm not up there, we can send those guys up and tell them, hey, here's what we need to get done, Patrick, and he's able to get that done with those guys. So just very reliable, comes out, does a great job for us as always, and nice to get the first points on the board. Certainly would have been great to have a touchdown, but to come out with points on the board is the big thing for us, for sure. Okay, after the fourth down stop, this is the ensuing drive and the finish. This is the first points of the year. Nice to see Patrick get in there and get his first kick. First points of the year. And again, just going back, kind of back to the future here, we go back to Hunter Halfley as our holder. You know, Hunter was our holder a couple of years ago. Last year, we had Austin Anthony do it, who was really good, but went back to Hunter this year. Actually, we went back to him just recently. We were using a couple other guys and just decided Hunter's just so reliable. We just went back with him and did a phenomenal job. And Patrick, obviously, is very comfortable with him as well. So good snap, good hold. Bulldogs on the board.
Play number four in our Big Eight is Wingate sophomore quarterback Kyle Johnson, 28-yard scamper. And, Coach, you know, I was talking about this in the position previews with Coach Long and other places that, you know, this might be the first time in a long time we've had a quarterback that wants to tuck it and run and can get you the 3 or 4 yards. Not that the other guys couldn't, but that wasn't their thing.
Right.
Kyle can definitely do both, and he had a couple of nice runs. You know, this one for 28 yards, and got to be careful at times, get down, but he slid down nicely a few times.
Sure.
A couple of times he got those extra yards.
Yeah, and that's you're exactly right. Kyle's got great feet, but he did a good job, but he's got to learn to get on the ground. Most of the time we can afford to take a lot of shots on our quarterback. So, you know, we're still a throwing team. We're still a team that likes to throw the ball, and, you know, that's an area that we need to obviously improve from this first game on. But it also showed that Kyle has the ability to do some other things and hurt teams in other ways. And that was a great thing. This run was a great example of that. You know, we're kind of slugging along a little bit, and all of a sudden he pops a big 28-yard run, gets us down in the red zone, and sets up our next touchdown. And just, you know, like I said, I'd like to see him even things out a little bit in the passing game, but he did a good job of leading the team today on Saturday. He did a good job of just kind of maintaining his poise, and as he can just continues to settle in, he'll get better and better and better. All right, this is a second down on this drive, second and one. Kyle doing a nice job here. Just a little quarterback read on the backside. Pretty much every team in the country uses some version of this. Doing a nice job here, just getting the pull, then being a good athlete out here in space, getting a good block from Will Poteet out in the open field. And then this is what one of the things Kyle does really well. He just accelerates, he can hit the hole. He's got really good feet. Punches it through there, although we're getting on him a little bit for kind of stumbling here at the end. Instead of getting in the end zone, you know, from the sideline, I thought for sure he was going to be in the end zone. Just with the way things went down here, when you kind of see it open up and you can see him hit this thing, and it really looked like he was going to hit it. You kind of catch the last part of it here, but you know, really thought he was going to go all the way. Just one trip up and puts us in position for our next play. As a matter of fact,
play number five in our Big Eight here in Week One, in the 38-10 win over Limestone, was the Lawrence Pittman touchdown run, the first TD of the year. Now, Coach, if you gave me 10 guys to pick to say who's going to score the first touchdown for us, Ryan, you know, nothing against Lawrence.
Right.
You know, it just, he wouldn't have been that guy. Just,
right.
You could tell right there from his first carry, though, his first collegiate carry. I mean, he meant business out there. He was big bruising back, whereas Mike and Nestor are more of the shifty guys.
Yep.
You know, interesting play call here. Limestone declines the holding penalty.
Right.
Could have made it second and 17 and said it was third and 7 from the 8. He punches it in, get on the board.
And really, O-line did a nice job there. kudos to the coaching staff. They're seeing kind of what they were in. Hey, here's what we're looking for. Saw the favorable numbers for us, and we're able to punch it home. And Lawrence obviously doing a great job as a true freshman coming in. It's hard for any true freshman to play. Last year we started five true freshmen at different times, and you know you're gonna have your struggles when you do that. And I think this year we haven't had to start any true freshmen along the line there, and so we can work Lawrence in, and as he continues to learn the offense, continues to learn college football. And he certainly showed that he belongs in terms of physically being able to handle the game and play at that level. And he'll just continue to get better and better and better and getting a little bit more involved in the offense. I mean, right now he's still learning it all. So he's, you know, we kind of limit what he does. But, you know, I can see him down the road becoming a major part of the offense as he continues to grow in that knowledge of the offense. This is our freshman Lawrence Pittman in the backfield. Offensive line doing a great job. Just putting a hat on a hat, when you have a great back like this, or great backs like we have in general, you know, we put a hat on a hat, we think we've got a chance of getting the ball in the end zone. And nice to see Lawrence get his first touchdown of his career.
And great vision here too, Coach, to find that left side.
He does a great job here. It's really, this is a big league cut right there. I mean, look at the, you know, 220 pounds to be able to cut like that. That's a nice job. Lowers the shoulder as he goes through the hole. Great job by Daniel Owens here, getting off on the linebacker. Knocking the linebacker by the hole, Cabell Cantrell, our offensive center here, just getting enough of the nose here, of the two-eye technique right there, just getting enough piece of him to keep him off balance, and good job all around here. Matt Gibson doing a great job, and again Lawrence punching it through for the touchdown.
Play number six in our Big Eight here for Week One. Nick Napolitano, we mentioned him earlier, had a forced fumble. This time, a forced fumble off the quarterback turns into 6 points.
Right.
Steven Jacobs recovers it. So a couple things there. Your two preseason all-conference defensive ends, mm-hmm. both in on the play. Both of them seniors, been together a long time.
Right.
And then the other part of it, Jacobs, you know, just carrying offensive linemen in the end zone. And then you know, we learned later he's getting a cramp as he's heading the end zone. At first he didn't know he scored. I mean, that was a wild play.
It was a very wild play and a very needed play at that particular point. It was still, you know, at that point, still fairly close game. It was nice to get a big touchdown there. Plus, you know, it's such a boost when you can score on defense. It just picks everything up, picks both sides up. Again, a game we scored twice in it. I'll say this, the negative is then you got to go right back out there again. And, you know, like you said, Steven was starting to cramp up. Cornell was starting to cramp up. We had some guys that were starting to feel the heat. But I'll say this particular team, we've got as much depth as we've had in a long time. We maybe have had more talented teams over the years, but this team is as deep as what we've had in a long time. So it was nice to see them, some of the younger guys come in and be able to pick up the slack there. You know, great job again by Knapp, just beating his offensive lineman, stripping the ball out. Jacobs being on the spot here and getting a better shot from the end zone. Again, Knapp just a very savvy football player. Fundamentally very sound, just doing a great job here, long arming, pushing off, the offensive lineman runs into his own back here, unfortunate for them, fortunate for us. Knapp gets the strip, and again, good job of just attacking with his arms. Attack with the arms, ball comes out, Jacobs being in position, you can see, he kind of sees what's going on, and he just picks it up, kind of carries the offensive lineman in the end zone, and that, unfortunately, that's all we get right there. Everybody's excited. Everybody's pumped up, we gotta love that.
Our seventh play here in Week One of the Big Eight with Joe Reich here against Limestone was Brandon Hathaway, safety, returned that fumble for 49 yards. And again, Coach, you know, you take for granted a guy being able to scoop and score. It's not difficult. It's not easy, I should say, to reach down, pick the ball up, and able to, you know, gain your speed and get down the field. And he did. And
very difficult.
Not only did Hathaway score a touchdown, he had some bruising hits out there as well as that third safety with Jay and John out there. Big play. And you know, stretch the margin a little bit more.
Brandon's going to be a great player. He's a great competitor, and you could see that he really stood out that he's out there competing at a whole nother level. You know, obviously in practice you think you see those things, but you don't really see the competitive level and the competitive fire to see him in a game. Brandon's going to be a great player. Needs to continue to learn the defense, continue to learn some of the little discipline things. But in terms of athletic ability and the ability to go strike somebody and make plays, I think we saw some good examples of that on Saturday for sure. And again, like you mentioned, a great pickup. That's not an easy pickup, running full speed, bend down there, pick the thing up, and then get it in the end zone. So great to see two consecutive plays like that. And again, just it was nice to see the defense score 14 points on a day that they only gave up 10. So great job by Rashawn Jordan, the defensive staff, and certainly excited about that, the defense moving forward. All right, this is play 7, 17-3 at this point, just into the fourth quarter. A big play here. Again, Knapp doing a great job, pinching off the backside, beating his man, beating the tight end across his face. Gets enough penetration here to affect the mesh. So the quarterback in the back kind of off on the timing here because of Knapp's penetration. Ball pops out. Hathaway in position right here on the backside. Just staying disciplined on the backside, picks it up, scoops it up, and goes the distance for the score. Again, a very athletic play, picking that thing up and getting it in the end zone here. Again, you see it from the backside. Really, you got a good shot of Knapp here. You're getting up underneath the tight end. This kid's a good football player, this tight end, too. We had a lot of respect for him after watching the tape. Good job by Knapp, getting underneath, getting the ball stripped out. Hathaway, again, on the run. Tough pickup. Gets it going. All the way down to the end zone. We like that. Great first game for Brandon Hathaway.
Our final play here of the Big 8 in week number 1 was Nestor Lantigua, 41-yard carry. It was the biggest offensive play of the day. And, got run down there at the end, but he did end up punching in and scoring on that drive. And, Nestor, a senior guy, I interviewed Lawrence after the game, and he said, Nestor and Micah have been great helping me into this transition. And great to see Micah score before that, right, and Nestor get one as well there on Saturday.
Yeah, and I was going to include Micah's touchdown in there as well. If we could have 9, that would have been certainly in that mix as well. Micah certainly did a great job all game. Nestor's pop in the long run. Really, I think the game was pretty much decided at that point, but to kind of ice things away, it was great to see Nestor pop one through there. You know, we saw that last year. Nestor had a great yards per carry average, had the best on the team last year. So it'll be neat to see how that trio continues to grow throughout the year. Then we have Blake Hayes, another tailback that we expect to see in the next couple of weeks as he's coming off a knee injury. So we've got a stable back there. Now it's just going to be a question of how we use all four of them and who gets most of the carries, and you know, just kind of revolve those guys through and let them do the work. And again, kudos to the offensive line for setting up with those touchdowns, and that's the most yards rushing we've had in a long time. And it was neat to see that group kind of come, that offensive line group come together over the course of the preseason. This is eventually putting the icing on the cake, but a good drive here. I believe almost this whole series was runs coming down here. We had a couple series like that towards the end of the game. And this is Nestor Lantigua popping it through on the ISO. Fullback ISO, great job by Denwin Clark of ISOing the Mike linebacker here, popping it up in, and again, Nestor just popping through there. Would have liked to see him get in the end zone, but again, he does a great job here with just popping through. Again, good job of the offensive line, good job by Denwin here, popping the linebacker, getting just enough movement. Again, Daniel Owens here, getting a shot here, kicking this out here. Again, Cabell over on this side. Along with Brandon Hurt, getting some movement there, popping the ball through. Again, Nestor finishing off doing what he does right there.
So that was your Big 8 plays here for week 1 against Limestone. Coaches asked you after the game, it's been great to prep for a week 1 because, you can focus on yourself. You've had preseason to go through, but now is when the guys really can prove their worth off the field. What can you learn? How fast can you learn it? And how fast can you improve? It feels like, to me, this is one of the most important practice weeks of the year because this is the chance to have proof and let's go out there and correct it the next week.
There's no doubt. They talk about that. This should be your greatest improvement is between the first game and the second game because now everybody's been out there. You can feel what it's like to be in the first game. You get a sense of how your role fits into the whole overall plan of things. And that's from everybody, the scout team, the coaching staff, the training staff, everything. Now you've had your run at it. So this was a good run for us, and now we're expecting our guys to do that much more. We have a little bit of film on our next opponent, which we didn't have any film on our last opponent. So to have some film on this opponent, personnel-wise, scheme-wise, and be able to go out and say, okay, here are the things that we want to be able to do. and scheme them up and then have guys look at that film and, you know, try to digest all that. That's great things.
Coach, we appreciate your time. Best of luck against St. Augs.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
All right. This has been week one of the Big Eight with Joe Reich. Again, join us next week. Week two will be the Wingate Road Game 8 at St. Augustine's coming up next week.